Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I was facing all the sunlight while our feet swung freely from the bridge. The bridge. I am sorry that I haven't done a video in a little bit. I was going to film my keto crate, my April box, but it got here super late because of a horrific incident that happened at the facility that it was coming out of. So that delayed it a lot. So I didn't really get it until like the second to last week of April. So I just ended up opening it on my Instagram stories. I've got a couple reviews. If you go into my highlights, you can see like my reviews of a few products on there, but it wasn't that exciting. I was actually super disappointed with it because 5 of the products in there were not vegetarian friendly, which is usually not the case with Keto Crate. Like there's usually 2 to 3 products that are not vegetarian, but this time it was 5. So I was kind of disappointed with this crate. But today we are going to do the VSG tag finally. Sorry y'all, my camera audio cut out in one of my clips, but I was just saying that the VSG tag I found from my YouTube friend, as told by Dawn. She's incredible. Please go watch her videos and subscribe. She is, I think, 3 months or so post-op. She has been so helpful to me on this journey, so go over to her channel and subscribe. So I'm going to answer the questions from the VSG tag like she did in her video. I think she did do it post-op, 6 weeks post-op, but I feel like doing it now, so that's when I'm gonna do it. Oh, and first, if you haven't liked this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, please. I really appreciate it. And make sure to subscribe, especially if you are considering weight loss surgery or you've had weight loss surgery. This is about to go into hyperdrive weight loss surgery channel because my surgery is June. Well, that's the first question, actually. When is your surgery? My surgery is June 2nd. So it is April, no. What is it today? It's May 1st. Yeah, it is May 1st. So we are a month out from my surgery. So I will start my liquid diet 2 weeks before surgery. So you're about to see a lot of VSG weight loss surgery content on this channel. So the first question, as I said, was what is your surgery date? It is June 2nd, 2021. Very excited. Number 2, what state are you having your surgery? I'm in the beautiful state of Kentucky. Number 3, are you cash pay or insurance patient? I am an insurance patient. I qualified because my BMI was over 40 and I did 6 months with my doctor, my primary care provider. I did 6 months with him and that allowed me to qualify through my insurance. So they pay, my deductible is $3,000 and it's $3,000. So it's your deductible plus 15% is what I'll end up paying. So I think I've almost hit my deductible for the year just from like appointments and those 6 months visits. So I don't know how much it's gonna be, but it's definitely not gonna be like, I don't know, we'll see. I'm always surprised when I get the bills. I've actually gotten like 3 bills recently for the endoscopy that I had that were kind of surprises. The last one was $100. So in total, my endoscopy was like $1,200 and that kind of scares me, but that was, you know, I haven't hit my deductible yet. So I'm hoping once I hit my deductible, the bills are not as high. We'll see. Okay, next question. Why weight loss surgery? Ooh, that's a loaded question. So I talked about this in my like welcome to my channel video that has since been deleted because there were some things I shared on that I wasn't comfortable with people in my like actual life scene. And since that video, they have found my YouTube channel, unfortunately. So I deleted that video. I need to make another like welcome to my channel video. But my reasoning for wanting weight loss surgery is because I have failed so many times in the past to maintain my weight loss. I've, you know, lost 20 pounds. I've only had one like major weight loss and that was in like March of 2019, I found out I was pregnant. And the year prior to that, I had lost 60 pounds and I was doing amazing. Like, I was more fit than I've ever been in my entire life. So things were going well, and then I got pregnant. And I just slipped back into really bad habits. I started eating a lot during the pregnancy, and then after the pregnancy, I put on about 90 pounds. I think it was like 60 pounds during the pregnancy, and then I dropped down, instantly gained that back up, and then gained an additional 20 something pounds after my pregnancy. So at that point, I think it, like, after I had gained up to that 90 pounds, I was just kind of over it. Like, I knew I needed to do something, and I decided I was ready to break the cycle of gaining and losing. And I do still kind of want to have another child. I'm not 100% sure, and I know I had a lot of complications with my pregnancy. I had preeclampsia and, you know, really, really dangerously high blood pressure that comes along with that. And it could be weight associated. It's most likely associated because I was at such a high weight during that pregnancy. Actually, when I got pregnant, I'm the weight that I am now. So I know that I don't want to have another child even at this weight after I've lost almost 100 pounds. So I really need to get down to a low enough weight where I feel comfortable having another child. And I think that weight loss surgery will get me there. I don't think I can do it by myself. So, and I have the means to be able to do weight loss surgery. So that's what I'm choosing. And I'm going to do it. Next question. This is going to be a long video. We're already 7 minutes in. There's 14 questions. We are on question number four. So number five, what type of surgery are you having? I decided on the VSG surgery. I initially went in wanting to have gastric bypass, but the surgeon kind of talked me out of it. And like the things he said, my only thing that was holding me back from VSG was the like potential to have really, really bad heartburn. I heard that like if you already have heartburn and acid reflux, you don't want to have VSG because it could make it worse. And then he kind of explained that that probably won't be an issue if I have like a hiatal hernia, like they'll fix it. And he put me on a omeprazole, which is like prescription Prilosect. So he didn't seem to be that concerned, and he just thought VSG would be a better surgery for someone at my starting weight, for someone of my age. Yeah, so that he convinced me, and that's what I'm going with at this point still. They did say I could change my mind after this like seminar when I went in for my initial meeting with the bariatric center. They said some people do change their mind about what surgery they want to have after their bariatric seminar, and mine is May 27th, so I'll let you guys know if I change my mind. Next question, favorite vitamin brand. I don't even want to get into vitamins right now because I'm still salty about those Nutrimen gummy vitamins. If you all watched one of my videos, I talked about it, I think, but they were just real shady about like quality control of their vitamins. Like, one batch I got was amazing, tasted delicious. And then the next two batches were horrible. I couldn't even chew them. They made me sick. So really upset with them. So I don't have a favorite vitamin. I'm not taking any vitamins at this current moment. I did see in my packet of paperwork that I got about the upcoming seminar that I have to go to that they do some sort of vitamin program. Like my bariatric center does. I assume I'll get more information about it, but it looks like some sort of subscription program where they'll like send the vitamins to you directly to your house or something. So I might just do that just because it seems simple. I don't know. What complications have you had or do you fear you will have? Oh, do we have to talk about this one? Well, obviously dying. I really don't want to die. I'm like, I'll be really pissed off if I die, but I don't like to think about it. I know it's a pretty low risk. I'm pretty low risk for dying. Being cut open all the way and them not being able to perform the surgery laparoscopically, that scares me too, because I know the healing process is longer and you have a big scar down the front of your stomach, which I wouldn't prefer. I would rather have the laparoscopic scars if possible. So yeah, that's a fear. I guess like the leaking. I mean, I can handle anything that comes to me as long as I don't die. Like that's the main one. Just, I really don't want to die. But yeah, dying, don't want that. So as long as that doesn't happen, I can handle anything that comes my way. What has been the best part of the journey? Definitely, I don't remember what Dawn said for this question. I feel like she might have said the same thing, like now that I'm thinking about it. I haven't watched her video since she put it out, and that was like 3 months ago, 4 months ago. So the best thing has absolutely 100% been the community that I've found in the weight loss surgery community on Facebook, on Instagram, on YouTube, like the social media, and on TikTok. Like I've got a new family there too. I literally would not be at this point in my journey. I probably would have like given up. I would not be here without the people that I've met throughout this journey. Special shout out to my friend Sandy. Her name is VSG Queen Diet on Instagram, VSG underscore Queen Diet on Instagram. She has been such a huge everything to me. Like this girl came and cleaned my house because she knew that I was stressed out and like really struggling to keep my house clean with the baby. Like she came and cleaned my house and I met her on Instagram. Like what kind of online friend does that? And I would have never met her if it wasn't through me starting this weight loss surgery journey. So I'm super, super grateful for all of the amazing people that I've met on this journey. And even the people that I haven't met in person, like the people that I just talked to or follow, people that probably have no clue I exist, like you all have been so helpful. Yeah, that is definitely the greatest part of this journey so far. My starting weight. Well, my starting weight when I first went to the doctor for my 6 months of medically supervised weight loss, that was 360 pounds. My current weight is around, my weigh day is tomorrow. I'm pretty sure my last weight was like 263. So almost 100 pounds lost, yeah. And I'm hoping that my starting weight or my surgery day weight, I have like my goal, what I want it to be written down because I can't go below 252 pounds. I have to, stay above that just for insurance purposes. So my goal weight is like 253, something like that. I think I actually have my pre-op goal weight is 260. So as long as I hit that 100 pounds lost mark before surgery, I will be very happy with myself. Yeah, that'll be awesome. So my goal weight, that is the next question. My goal weight, I don't know. According to my doctor, it's like 180, I think he said. But my personal goal weight, I've never really been below 180 as a like fully matured adult person. Like anything before that, you know, I was a lot shorter, probably in like the fourth grade. I think I was like 160 pounds in the fourth grade. So as a 9-year-old, I was 160 pounds, which right now 160 at 5'6.5" tall, that would be like a good normal BMI for me to be. So that could be a goal, but like I can't even imagine what my body would look like at that weight. The lowest weight I've ever seen my adult body with, you know, boobs and everything is 180 pounds. And that was thin to me. Like I thought I was, I mean, I did think I was fat at the time. And like people actually did say I was fat a few times. Like on Surgery, have I done this before? I have this like vivid memory of being called fat. By like a random stranger that was like driving by. And I have a picture of that night and the outfit that I was wearing. I was around 180 pounds then. I will insert that picture. You all can judge for yourself. But I mean, I thought I was fat, but now looking back, I'm like, dang girl, you were not fat. Like that is a perfect weight to be. So around 180 would be the goal. And then maybe like try and build some muscle. So I don't know, if I get to 180, I'm gonna like stop worrying about my weight and just focus on like fitness and muscle building. And if I get down below that, that's fine. If I go up from there, not too much. I'd like to stay around 180 and I'll be happy. What are the top three things on your weight loss journey bucket list? Well, let's pull it up. We talked about that in the last video, obviously, but I don't know if I top three. You know what, I'm gonna insert the whole list again, but the ones that I'm gonna do hopefully before getting surgery is ride a roller coaster, maybe indoor skydiving, and then probably spelunking, like going crawling through the cave and whatnot. So those are probably the three that I'll do pre-op, and then the other ones I will come for after surgery, after I'm all healed up. Who has been your biggest encouragers during this journey? Well, I already talked about my social media family, my friend Sandy. Obviously, she's been a huge supporter for me. And my number one, definitely my husband. He is literally incredible. Like, he never complains about me going to the gym or having doctor's appointments. Like, he is always there and never complains or questions it. Like, he just is a supporter 100%. And I feel so bad, especially in my Facebook groups. I see so many marriages like falling apart because of the surgery, just like completely being obliterated because of this whole process. And he has not wavered in anything. He has been behind me 100% ever since I brought it up to him. He's been incredible. And if you have someone in your life that is not supporting you, like your husband or your partner, I'm sorry, because you deserve better than that. And everybody deserves a husband or a partner like my husband. So if you don't have that, I don't know, I'm sorry. Next, was this the last one? Yep. What would be the advice to someone thinking about having weight loss surgery? Okay. So, I mean, obviously I haven't had the surgery yet, so my answer will probably change. I may do this again, like some of these questions again, after I've had the surgery, to see if my perception of any of them changes. But my advice would be to start your habits early. Like, I know a lot of programs, like especially if you're self-pay, they are like, okay, you do 3 months of these classes, meet with a nutritionist, don't gain any weight, then we'll give you surgery. I don't think that is a good route to go. I think doing it the way I did it is the best way to go, even though I haven't had surgery yet. So this is all like, I'm speculating. I think that I am gonna be better than the people that didn't have as long pre-op, like the whole pre-op process. Because I started this whole journey in July, so it's been almost a year. It'll be 11 months from the time I started the journey to the time I'm having surgery. So I had 11 months to think about this, process this, get my life in order, get my eating in order. And that has been the biggest thing. I was a food addict. I needed it. I needed food. I needed to order ice cream. I needed to order cake. I needed to order fast food. I needed to eat fast food every single day. I was an addict and it was scary. I was spending so much money on food. It was insane. I felt like a crazy person because I could not get this under control and I was literally killing myself. And stopping that behavior cold turkey is hard, and it's not gonna work because you're gonna slip up. But if you have enough time, if you've got 11 months like I did to like make those lifestyle changes and not just like go on a diet, not just make the changes for 3 months or whatever, like if you have 11 months, almost a year to commit to a lifestyle change and changing the way you eat and becoming active, like that I think is gonna make a huge difference. So you can use the tool of weight loss surgery and be super successful with it. Now, I don't know if I'm gonna be successful. I could like epically fail at this, but I think since I've already lost 100 pounds, I've already got a good fitness habit. I've researched, like I understand what foods to put in my body to help me lose weight. I track my calories. I've gotten in such a good habit. I've been tracking for 250 days on my Fitness Pal. Never missed a day, 250 days straight. I have tracked my calories. And I think those habits that I've created over the past 11 months are here to stay. And when I have surgery, they're not going anywhere. As soon as I'm able to, I'm gonna get back into my fitness routine. I've already cut out pretty much all sugar from my diet. A little added sugar, but I mean, the amount of sugar that I eat and the carbs that I eat are still super low compared to what it was, especially. I eat around like 50 to 70 grams of carbs per day. And I keep the sugar really low. I don't feel addicted to sugar anymore. Sugar does not have a control over my life anymore like it did. And I feel bad for the people that don't have that under control before they go into surgery, because that is just a recipe for disaster in my opinion. Because once you're all healed up, once you don't feel restriction anymore, especially with VSG, a lot of people say they don't get dumping from eating sugar, they can eat whatever they want. If you don't fix all of that before you go into surgery, surgery's not gonna work for you. It's not going to work. And I've seen it so many times, people talking about it on my Facebook groups and Instagram and YouTube, people regain or don't lose. It's because you didn't get your mind right, you didn't get past your food addiction before surgery. So my advice, get past all of that stuff. Take the time that you need before surgery or you're not going to have as much success. And I understand some people, they need the surgery before that to happen because they just can't do it. And maybe the surgery will help them a little bit. But I think to have optimal success with surgery, you have to get past your food addiction and whatever's going on with you, like mentally, you need to be in a really, really good place before the surgery. So that's my advice. Sorry, this was such a long video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all of you. Please make sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe. And I love you all. Bye.